Have CDs finally had their day? I mean, we all know that vinyl has made a comeback, but why is that?
We're going to weigh the pros and cons of pressing physical copies of your next release to help you decide which option is best for you.
Hey, how's everyone doing? From British Atlantic, I'm singer-songwriter Marcin Valley from Canada.
And I'm music web designer Russ Piper-Smith from Scotland.
And you're watching B-Sides, a show empowering musicians with knowledge and advice. If you're new here, subscribe.
So I think we're going to kick things off by looking at selling CDs, like what are the pros and cons. So I think, Marcio, as a musician yourself, as someone who has printed CDs and sold CDs, what are the pros of selling them?
Well, the pro of selling them is that you make income. But I mean, I think where we can actually sell them still are at shows. You know, very few people are buying CDs online anymore. Unless, in my situation, if there's a pre-order or a crowdfund. So the question is that the death of the compact disc? Or is that the death of physical releases in general, I guess we should say? And I don't know, what are your experiences as a music fan? You know, when was the last time you bought a CD? When do you buy CDs? What sort of situations actually encourage you to buy a CD and why?
I think pre-streaming and pre-like iTunes, I had hundreds of CDs. I was obsessed with buying CDs because that was I collected CDs. That was how I consumed my music.
Same.
But now, because like streaming and digital downloads are so much more, it's just so much easier to get what you want instantly. I find that I've been buying less and less CDs. And really, the only times that I buy CDs are if I'm at a show, and that tends to be if it's a support act that I thought was just really great and I need to buy their CD so I don't forget who they are, I'll buy a CD there. Or it'll be as a reward for a crowdfund. Because if I'm giving someone money for a crowdfund, and it's like, say, for example, it's like $5 for the download or $7 or $8 for the CD, I'll go for the CD because often it's going to be signed as well if it's like a crowdfund. So I like to have that something that's a little bit more personal, something physical, tangible that I can hold. So yeah, they're the two scenarios that I tend to buy CDs in.
Yeah, for me, I'm doing a lot of streaming nowadays when I listen to music because it's basically like you have an endless music library at your fingertips.
Yeah, it's just convenient. It's so much more convenient.
It is, but also, you know, I know people might hate on that thinking, oh, the artist isn't getting paid as much money, but you know, in the other end of it, I mean, if you listen to a song hundreds of times, they're actually going to end up getting more money than the dollar you probably would have spent on it. And really, they probably would have only got like 30 to 50 cents from that anyway. So in some ways, you know, depending on the artist and how many streams they are getting, you know, they might actually be getting more in the long run. But I guess the question here is staying focused on the CD and the physical format. You know, for me, it's definitely been shows. That's where I get CDs. And the thing I would just suggest as a side note is don't have them priced too high. You know, remember, unfortunately, the value of music has gone down. We can all cry about it. I think we've done this for years. I think it's time that we suck it up and realize it just is. You know, the value is now put on the artist as a whole, you know, attending concerts, merchandise, not so much on the actual music. So, you know, don't have it for $20 a CD. You just can't do that anymore. If it's a full-length album with, you know, at least 10 songs, possibly more, I would say don't go more than $10. I mean, I've picked up CDs from artists that are only $5 for a full-length because it was only $5 and they're an opening act. And I probably wouldn't have gotten it if it was 10 or more dollars. But $5, yeah, sure, for an album, sure. You know, a lot of times there's no booklet in it anymore, but that's okay. I mean, if I paid more, I'd expect more. For $5 just to get a physical copy of the CD, you know, that is fine for me. I could have just listened to them and not bought a CD. So, you know, that's kind of where you've got to gauge. And you also have to remember, if you're an independent artist, you know, you can't, I know often I see younger bands, they want to charge the same amount as somebody else who put out a CD, thinking like, well, that their CD's, you know, $10 or $20, whatever it is, or $15. But how much went into making that album? How much time, how much money went into it? Probably at least $100,000 to $300,000 at the minimum for a major label band. Maybe you put $5,000-$10,000 into it, you know, so you have to kind of be realistic about that, you know. But moving on in the idea of CDs, it's the question is, are people really getting it? You and I are still getting it, but are the general population still wanting to pick up CDs? You know, what do you think?
Generally, no. I think more and more people are just, they are wanting streaming because, like you said, it's that endless kind of library. Anything you want to listen to, it's going to be there. And you don't have to wait for it. You know, if you're ordering a CD online, you have to wait for it to be delivered. And if you're going into a store, you know, and so many music stores are closing down now, it's harder to find physical music anywhere other than shows, I think.
I think a lot of bands for pre-orders are making sure the CD arrives like on time at the same time as the release. Although that doesn't always
work out under
their hands.
A lot are offering the digital download in addition to the CD. So, you know, if you're waiting 3 weeks for the CD, at least you're getting the music first. And it's sort of just like a, I guess it's just like a token gesture, like a thank you in advance. Here's the audio, but the physical part, which is the kind of special part, I guess, is going to be with you soon. It's just going to take a bit longer because it's that, you know, snail mail, as they call it.
So would you say that, you know, the CD CD and vinyl, any physical release medium really was the only way you can get music in the past, like many, many years ago. But would you say now they're more so a novelty item? You know, something that people just kind of want. Again, why people are mostly getting this at shows rather than actually going to a store to get it is probably more so for the memorabilia aspect of it. You know, yeah. To actually have a physical copy of
it's something. Almost like CDs and vinyl have become merch rather than like mm-hmm. the main kind of product, I guess. Because I think a lot of people who buy a CD or a vinyl, they're probably still going to be streaming the album, you know, if they're, you know, sitting on their computer or if they're listening to their iPod or whatever they're doing, they're going to be listening to a digital version of that. Mm-hmm. So a lot of the time, I think it is really just for display that they might buy the CD or the vinyl because, you know, the artwork looks really cool. So it's nice to showcase that or to have some kind of physical ownership, I guess. Like, because I mean, I would still say, like, I sold most of my CDs as when I started listening to a lot of stuff on streaming, but mm-hmm. there was some that I still wanted to hold on to because they had sentimental value to them.
Right.
So I can sort of see that maybe sometimes people will buy an album on CD or vinyl for that reason.
No, exactly. And, you know, you think it might be a generational thing, but I actually had an experience at a concert recently and I was ridiculously surprised that it was mostly teenage girls that were very upset that this band had sold out of CDs. And I remember looking at my wife being like, really? And I doubt most of them are actually going to go home and rip the CD. You know, if they even have a CD player, most laptops don't even have CD players anymore. Yeah. I think I have like one, you know, on my one old laptop. So, you know, and I'm pretty sure that with purchasing the CD, I'm pretty sure with this particular band, there was a link to download the album if you wanted to. So again, I really think it's almost like a glorified download card now, you know, it's like, here's a physical copy. You could play it if you want, maybe in your mom or dad's like car, the old
maybe
car.
They still thought have a it was CD like player. A retro thing.
I mean, I still have a CD player. What am I saying in my car? But, and it's a brand new car, but, yeah. So, you know, maybe that's kind of the thing, but I was surprised by that. As an artist, I was really happy that people still want a physical copy of something, mm-hmm. you know, and it's not just, you know, I guess people that grew up with it that want it, you know, and again, you know, it could be wanting not just a physical copy as a means of a memory, but also having the artwork right there or something that's actually physically and tangibly there, which, you know, more people, I think, want than we give credit for just because it's not being purchased as much. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. But that does lead me to the idea of if you are going to get something physical, if you have the budget for it, maybe look into vinyl. But, you know, it's a lot more costly. But it's, I think, even more of a novelty item. And beyond that, I actually know people who love listening to music on vinyl. You know, they'll download they'll stream or they'll listen to on vinyl rather than listening on CD because it's more of an experience for them, you know, especially if they're really into that. So that's something to consider. I would say, personally, if you are going to actually go on tour, if you have a tour planned, you know you're going to hit the road, you know there's going to, I mean, there's no guarantee, but you know there's going to be people there. Maybe you're opening up for a large or even a semi, you know, medium-sized band. If you think you're going to actually be playing for an audience at the end of the day, I would definitely print something. I would get either CDs or vinyl, depending on what you can do. However, if you are mostly staying at home, releasing music, which is okay, and if you're maybe just playing some off shows, maybe stick with digital until that kind of builds up, and then there might be a point where you think, I should maybe print something physical. You don't want to miss an opportunity. I've done that. We've missed an opportunity where, you know, people would have purchased a physical copy, but you didn't have them available. You know, you don't want to do that, but at the same time, gauge it. You know, there's pros and cons to doing this, and there's always risk. So you have to just take that chance and see what's right for you.
Yep, absolutely. And I think that's a good place for us to wrap things up. It's something we could talk about a lot more probably. But if you want more from us in the meantime, you can find us on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. And if you want to pick up one of our shirts, visit our website and use the coupon code BTARocks to receive 20% off your order.
This episode was brought to you by Social Surge, your source for social media marketing and music promotion. Check them out because they do what, Ross?
They keep the show live. And... If you would like to sponsor the show and become an official Bridger, join us on Patreon from as little as a dollar per month. Not only will you be able to showcase your band or brand to our amazing audience, but your support will allow us to keep bringing you weekly videos here at Bridge the Atlantic.